Episode number 373. But the knife unfortunately, we ought to say skillfully, come in contact with the steel bosc, which at that period, like a cuirass, defended the chests of women. It had glided down it, tearing the robe, and had penetrated slantingly between the flesh and the ribs. Milady's robe was not the less stained with blood in a second. Milady fell down, and seemed to be in a swoon. Felton snatched away the knife. "See, my lord," said he, in a deep, gloomy tone, "here is a woman who was under my guard, and who has killed herself." "Beatrice, Felton," said Lord de Winter. "She's not dead, demons do not die so easily. Be tranquil, and go wait for me in my chamber." "But, my lord." "Go, sir, I command you." At this injunction from his superior, Felton obeyed, but in going out, he put the knife into his bosom. As to Lord de Winter, he contented himself with calling the woman who waited on Milady, and when she was come, he recommended the prisoner, who was still fainting, to care, and left them alone. Meanwhile, all things considered, and notwithstanding his suspicions, as the wound might be serious, immediately sent off a mounted man to find a physician. 58 Escape. As Lord de Winter had thought, Milady's wound was not dangerous. So soon as she was left alone with the woman whom the Baron had summoned to her assistance, she opened her eyes. It was, however, necessary to affect weakness and pain, not a very difficult task for so finished an actress as Milady. Thus the poor woman was completely the dupe of the prisoner, whom, notwithstanding hints, she persisted in watching all night. But the presence of this woman did not prevent Milady from thinking. There was no longer a doubt that Felton was convinced. Felton was hers. If an angel appeared to that young man as an accuser of Milady, he would take him, in the mental disposition in which he now found himself, for a messenger sent by the devil. Milady smiled at this thought, for Felton was now her only hope, her only means of safety. But Lord de Winter might suspect him. Felton himself might now be watched. Toward 4 o'clock in the morning the doctor arrived, but since the time Milady stabbed herself, however short, the wound had closed. The doctor could therefore measure neither the direction, nor the depth of it. He only satisfied himself by Milady's pulse that the case was not serious. In the morning Milady, under the pretext that she had not slept well in the night, and wanted rest, sent away the woman who attended her. She had one hope, which was that Felton would appear at the breakfast hour, but Felton did not come. Were fears realized? Was Felton, suspected by the Baron, about to fail her at the decisive moment? She had only one day left. Lord de Winter had announced her embarkation for the 23rd, and it was now the morning of the 22nd.